Hey there, Heather, hello there, it's Jeff Cutter Diamond. Welcome you to another OOTP Legends League Game of the Day. Today, we have the Colorado Rockies Legends and the San Diego Legends from Petco, and in a rarity, there's a game with no wind. Not even one teeny-weeny blowing breeze. Meanwhile, Colorado and San Diego are facing each other. Rockies are 6 games above 500 in 3rd place in their division. The Padres are 30 games above 500, but they're 2nd in their division. Weird. Anyway, Colorado and San Diego, as usual, better at home than on the road. In March, Colorado was 4-6, then 3 games above 500 in April. May, 9 games below 500, then June, 7 above July. They did, well, 18-8. They're 4-5 this month. The Padres are 7-3 this month with March. April, they were 16-11. May, 18-11. June, 17-10. July, only 2 games above 500. Their worst month by percentage. 7-2 this month. They're hot. Colorado, hitting-wise, in the National League, top 10 in everything minus strikeouts and stolen bases. Stolen bases, 12, strikeouts, 26. They strike out too many times. They are the NL leaders in on-base plus slugging, or OPS, and runs. And also hits, too. So they have a poignant offense and extra base hits, 530. The Padres, top 10 in some categories. Third in walks. They like to take walks on the beach. San Diego's pitching, not half bad. A pair of 7 places. Colorado's pitching is pathetic. Their BAP and defensive efficiency, the new age geek stuff. Anyway, Colorado sends Pedro Astacio to the mound against Jake Peavy. The Rockies have Juan Pierre at center, Matt Holliday at DH, Todd Helton at first, Cargo, Carlos Gonzalez in left, Troy Tulowitzki at short, Jeff Cirilla at second, Todd Walker will play third, Ellis Burks will play right field, and Brett Main will catch. The Padres have Dave Winfield at center, Tony Gwynn right, Agon at first, Freddie McGriff DHing, Mark Loretta at second, Brian Giles at left, Randy Reddy at third, Gene Tennant's catching, and Khalil Green will play shortstop. It's a Sunday game, and already it's 7-5 looking time, so it's a ton of fun. Almost every game we're going to be fun. Anyway, we're live. Today's game brought to you by Bank of America and T-Mobile. TV 13.5 for 3.8 euro and 144 wins. Let's see what he does. Rockies have won 4 out of 5 since the block. There's a progress. First pitch. Ground ball to the second, to the first, and the right towards me. Scoreboard. It's Pat Holliday, DH. Watch out on the steepy sinker. Goodbye. Another steepy sinker. Strikeouts there. Pistachio's 9-7. We're 4-4 second to right field. Takes Dave Winfield. Okay. Winfield to center. And a catch. Yeah, right here, right now. It was Tony Gwynn. Baltimore. What do you game he needs to do? Okay. Drink up the steel? Got it. It's 10 stone base. There you go. Third. To the wrong side of the field, there's a good butt. Down to the road, right in here. Right field, base hit. Good, run through the park. Suck. RBI single by Mr. Grip. 1-0. And here comes Loretta. Top of the third. Nice play, Loretta. Walking can't do it. This is a cool hit. This is set for Giles. Giles got about second in this play. So, Hawkins. Trying to get out of there, but Hawkins is going to win, but he can't go past the plate. PB to Cargo. He's gone. Save and save again. Struggle. He doesn't strike out this time. Look at the pop up. How's it? Cirillo? What's your hand? Really? Strike three. Well, that is the purple strikeout. Four strikeouts for babies in 2 minutes. Is Randy ready? Ready to left field into the club. Cargo. Tenants. Tenants grab on the short. He's playing first. That's two. Now you're going to see your feet. Little ground ball 6-3. Sasha gets one. Todd Walker on third base. The Rockets. On ball the second. And then he's playing Randy. Loretta, sorry. Randy Red playing third base. Ruth Burks. All four. Walker not feeling the greatest, so they went with Burks at right field. There's Maine. Maine trying to get a hit. Popped up right. Loretta. Yeah? On here. Here, ball hit the center. But it looks catchable. It is. Nice catch one here. The rock is getting blocked. That's nice. Back to the top of the deposits. And it's pretty good. Who takes a walk? That's good. Then, double play, one. Cirilla can't. Cirilla's in pain. Is able to shake it off. Maybe. Cirilla, to me, should be putting third base block in a second. Got him. Big strikeout on Adrian Gonzalez. Sorry, I said Cargo, which is wrong. Slide piece. Okay. Right, right. Goodbye. Fastball. Just one. Let the Padres go. 1-0. Well, probably not getting out of Pittsburgh in the 64th. Pittsburgh in the 9th. White Sox Legends up 16 in the 8th. Cincy and Milwaukee 0-0 through the 8th. 85 Rose up 6-4 in the 7th. Braves 20-4. Dodgers 2-0 in the 3rd. Tampa, those guys, Texas 8-6 in the 8th. So yeah, there's some game plan right now. Right here, right now. It's holiday. Anyways, on to Change. Breakout number 5. It's Elton. Elton, round ball to short. For the first gap, it's two. And here comes Cargo. He's gone. With the Jeff Diamond pitch. It is coming. So 6 breakouts for Phoebe. Winning. It's your right out. Loretta plays this one to left field. Right. Cargo. One down. For Giles. Giles slips on the left. Make Cargo go a little more back. And he retreats and pulls it in. That's two. And ready.
Strike three.
Strike out 2-3. Padres go down in order. 4, maybe going too well.
Strike 3.
Gone. He took the home run on the Jeff Diamond pitch. So that's the strikeout, and here comes Cirilla. Cirilla over the head of Randy Whitney. It's a single, and that's the first hit of the day by the Rock. Walker drives the ball to the left field. Over, but Giles is there to make feet on it today. Here comes Ellis. And he goes down. Slip the cutter by him. Don't throw me yet. Have them. Anyway, 1-0 Padres. And here comes Pennix. Pennix drives the ball to the right center. Oh, doctor! You can put a star on that, baby! Home run, power, 400 feet. Wow. The hero of the 1972 World Series begins. Thank goodness he was a Padre and a Padre legend catcher on the opening for Santiago. But, over Mon Fernandez. Surreal to left. That's a hit. 100 hit and rats. Winfield punts. It makes it foul. Winfield drives it to center field, gets it missing. And I believe, well, oh, Green thought about going to third base. and Silver Bullet. They are going to be bullpen, the liar, and Flames. On the left, Dixon base hit. We will stay at third. And Prince hitting streak is still attack, 15. Bases are juiced for Agon. No outs. Agon. That was such a blind shot. I thought it was out of the park. I bounced and hit the fence. That moved. Can I see the? Can I see the replay? Yeah, that ball was hit so fast. I thought, hit a line drive. Second and third, Again, drives to short. Only place the first. They get him. It's an RBI ground out. 5-0. And we'll cover Loretta. Loretta, the left field, he's catch. As it is. By Harbour. Yeah, and still don't work on him. It's Giles. Giles grounds out, but the Padres put not one, not two, but four runs on the board. That was the day for Stasio. PB will be up. It's Brett Main to start the sixth. Main ground ball to short. Throw. Get back. One down. Comes Pierre. Pierre. Ground ball to short. You're the first. Got it. That's two. The holiday. Popped up. Nice job by Peavy. Great pitching by him. He's done pretty well. Colorado has the over. And Darren Holmes is coming to the Yankees. Over the pitcher for the Rockies. Randy Reddy is ready. Pun intended. Randy slices at the center. It will drop into the glove. It does. I thought Spear was back to the park. There's Tenants who went his fifth round trip of the year. Last inning and goodbye. He went on a nice amount for a fastball. Here's Julio. Julio, the center field. Hit. Dave Winfield. Got him. It's like he's got him. But the Padres are still up 5-0. TV, let's see what he can do in the 7th. Todd Helton, they say, from Knoxville, Tennessee. He played for the University of Tennessee as a punter at Tennessee's ranked for the volunteer football team. Rich Cargo. Cargo swings the ball to the left field. Back. It's a get by that one. Cargo pants. 5-1. Well, there goes the shutout for two. It's too low. All four. This isn't looking good. It's too low. They go for steal. Safe. Too low. Stroll base number six. How about the third? Snag and throw the first. Nice job by Randy. Get that. Two outs. Better ball move. Here's Walker. Walker! Hit! He's going for the second run. Oh, he's out. Goodbye. He's going to try to jump up the 5-1. They might work up something. Only three hits for the walk. Walk, Jake, walk. Cargo's 34th home run. Pennant is 5th. A lot of action. 5-1, and now Holmes will throw to win. Ball. Hang on. Drive ball left field. And oh, doctor, you can put a star on that, baby. Hang on, says it's gone. Holmes is like, oh, are you kidding me? Buckles and Fuentes are doing that. Okay. Chopper. Someone get it? Nice hit by Pedrillo. Nobody's control. And that's as long as we get. Congratulations and salutations. Loretta. Loretta to right field. It just dropped. And Loretta, he ripped the second and he'll stay there. Here's Giles. Giles to left. It will drop, they say. And Rick will stay up here and face his approaches. Randy is a lady. What are the last which hitters? So anyway, Buckholz comes off on the right. Our little tournament a little bit. Randy is pushing. Randy Gumball, second for one. First for two. Double play. Run scores, but it is not an OBI. That's the rule. Runner on third for 10 minutes. Can he make it another run? Yes, he can. One on the right. Tap out the wall. I thought he would take it out for the second time today. Or 10 minutes from the second time. Looks like this game is taxing him. But never say never sometimes. And that was a terrible pitch. A wild pitch from Taylor. What did he score? Two outs. For Khalil. But he's out. Buckles gets the big strikeout there. Four runs though, he averages 9-1. And Evie is gonna get some run support. Burks swings by the left field and right into the glove with Ryan Giles. Here's Maine. Maine, that's a chopper. Someone get it! That ball is way up there. There's no wind to push it. Here's Pierre. Ground ball. Nice job by TV. Three up, three down. Rockies are looking desperate. 9-1. And they're going to make some changes. Yeah, you might as well. Bring this guy. George Hendricks coming to play. You might as well. Too many hoops to jump through. Har har. Anyways, Buckholz gets in the 99-1 fastball. Tony Gwynn. You're not going to gank Tony Gwynn. He says, come on, coach, don't be mine. Okay, then he grabs out. Maybe he should have. Maybe I'll check before the four of the eyes. He almost had a grand slam. I thought he did. And he's out. So Buckholz gets him. Three up, three down. Padre is still in 9-1. Comes up to the center field. He's thrown 100 pitches. But they are going to. Smart thing, warm up some balls. So Kirby and Jones are warming up just in case. So we have one to cover a little bit. Down ball, second. Now it doesn't mean that you're going to gank it even. It just practically means that just in case something happens. Hilton, that's a pop up. That's an easy pop up. For Kirby. And here comes Cargo, last chance. Only guy. And I'll take a walk. Now, Kubo. Got him, game set match. PD wins a 3-hit shutout. 9-1. Cargo was the only guy to touch him up for something major. So the Padres do it again. He's now 14-5. PB says he didn't even have much left in the tank. I believe you. Only Cargo, Cirillo, and Walker got hits. Two singles and a round tripper. San Diego did better in the home run department. Tenants and Cargo. Aegon. So both Gonzalez's hit home runs. PB now goes to 14-5, 3.65 ERA. Stachio drops to 9-8. Holmes did terrible. Buckholz did a good two innings of work. 42,000 fans saw the blood path. Three stars of the game. Manny Trio, Tyler Glasnow. They give him a second start despite him throwing 7 1/3 innings. If you're going to do it, the guy to get like 8 or 9 innings. And Bill Dickey, Jake Peavy deserves a top three because of what he did. He only gave up 3 hits in 9 innings. Sometimes it's not so easy. Anyway, here are your line scorers. The Mariners legends win 4-1. Moyer beats Palmer. Sasaki, 35th save. The Tigers, yeah, talk about the game being over. The 70 Orioles were up by 6 runs, and they give up 6 runs in the 9th. Tie game, Detroit wins in the bottom of the 10th. Hernandez beats Bird. Yeah, it's about, that's what I meant by saying game is never over. The Niners Blue Jays win in the 9th. Cox beats Musgrove. Joey Ward's 16th save. Cleveland Legends win 3-2. Sudden Sam McDowell beats Schilling with Joss's ninth save. The 84 Tigers win in the bottom of the 10th. Hernandez takes out Lee. The Astros Legends win 9-1. J.R. Richard beats Charlie Martin. The Twins Legends win 7-5. Dutch Leonard 16-8 beats Doc Holliday, who was looking for win number 19 but didn't get it. Pascal has ninth save. The Mariners Legends win in the bottom of the 9th. Charlton beats Kiki Calero. Royals with a shutout. Sever hanging on Wilson. Yankees Legends win 10-6. Guitry now 18-2. Amazing job. Clemens loses. David Robertson the save. The Texas Legends win 9-6. Honeycutt beats Cito. Cordero has 29th save. And yeah, Honeycutt did pitch for the A's once upon a time. The White Sox Legends win 6-3. Faber beats Grove. Wilhelm save number 38. The 85 Royals win 6-4. Black beats West. Quisenberry his 8th save. The Angels Legends win 4-2. Frank Tanana beats Casper with Percival's 29th save. And the 2020 Rays win 1-0, only about one hit. Glasnow beats Washburn. Curtis his 15th save. National League. The Twins win. Diamondbacks win 2-1, giving up only two hits. One was a home run to Johnny Evers. Johnny Evers hitting a home run. Wow. Randy Johnson beats Fred Beebe with Swindell's save. Hey, Michael. 97 Marlins win 7-1. It was the Brown Derby. Kevin Brown beat Kevin Brown with Saunders with the save. The Braves Legends win 6-1. Maddox beats Fernandez. The Marlins score 4 in the 9th to beat the 54 Giants. Leiter takes down Wilhelm. The Mets Legends win 6-2. Dickey beats Moose Haas. He's got 18 losses. The Cubs Legends win 11-5 as Ted Lilly beats Patrick Corbin. The 1980 Phillies win 17-9 in a home run derby against the 2007 Rockies. Well, only two home runs were hit. Steve Carlton beats Taylor Buchholz, who drops to 1-15. He was a much better reliever than a starter. The 57 Braves with a shutout win. Trowbridge, 4-14, beats Danny Martinez. Diamondbacks Legends win 10-1. Shelley beats Newcomb. 75 Reds win in the bottom of the 9th. Next to Joe Morgan, Carroll beats Mitch the Bitch Williams. Cardinals Legends 8-3. Blainier beats Bobby Friend. The 64 Cardinals win 5-4 in the 11th. Schultz beats Hanrahan. Brewers with the shutout. Aguero over Donnie Gullett. The Dodgers, well, they won in the bottom of the 9th. Paul Molitor hit a 2-run home run. Dodgers win 6-5, 3 of the 9th. Jansen beats Brian Wilson with Gagne's 35th save. And, of course, the Padres, Rockies, you saw. And guess what? There's no game. So we'll have stats day tomorrow. All right. AL Player of the Week is Al Kaline for the Tigers, 14-29. NL Player of the Week, Eddie Matthews, 13-28 this week. Kevin Millwood will miss 6 weeks. That's not good for the Braves. 9-9. Maybe he was the weak link, but yeah, him, Giles, and Henry Aaron. Well, Hank Aaron's gone for the year. So that puts Johnny Sane, who was a pretty good pitcher, Sane in Spain and Pray for Rain, at the 5-hole with Erica Flaherty coming into the bullpen. So Johnny Sane will have to come in and be the 5th guy. Maddox, Negro, Spahn, and Glavin spook a lot of people. Look how good they are. 71%. But they're only one game above Philly. That's how tough that series is. Quality starts for BBU 22. That's pretty good. Power rankings. The Cardinals are number one. The Rays number two. The Yankees number three. The top seasonal team is number 30 with the 1906 Cups. And the bottom part, the 82 Brewers, the 54 Giants, and the 29 A's are your bottom three. 2020 Rays are out, and the 1920 Indians are out. So anyway, we'll have stats day for you. Of course, we'll take a look at some stats and do some stuff. And then, of course, set you up for another time. Anyway, I'm Jeff Diamond. Adieu.